Hi everyone, and welcome back to our YouTube channel. In today's video, we're going to be defining what a PDF file is. Before we dive in, please give this video a thumbs up, and don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel with notifications turned on so you don't miss out on any future updates. Let's get straight into it. PDF stands for Portable Document Format, a versatile file format that allows people to present and share documents in a fast and reliable manner, irrespective of operating system, hardware, or the software used to view them. The International Organization for Standardization, or ISO for short, now maintains the PDF format as an open standard. And it's possible to include links, buttons, audio, form fields, business logic, and videos in a PDF. They can be electronically signed and viewed from a variety of devices, such as your computer or phone, and it's quite likely that any printable document you've downloaded from the internet, such as IRS or tax forms, was a PDF. And the quickest way to tell is by checking the extension, as PDF files have a .pdf extension. If you design a newsletter in Microsoft Word and share it as a .docx file, the standard Word format, there's no guarantee that everyone will be able to open it unless they have Word installed. Word documents are designed to be edited, so most of the formatting and text can be changed. On the other hand, PDF files are primarily intended for viewing rather than editing. One of the reasons PDFs are so popular is that they preserve formatting, so they're easier to share and look the same on all devices. That way, sharing as a PDF ensures everyone sees your document exactly as you intended. Let's talk about some more advantages of using the PDF format. When a user opens a PDF file in Adobe Reader, they can quickly search for what they're looking for. A table of contents can also be used to organize a PDF document, linking all the sections to the appropriate pages in the file. As long as free tools like PDF readers are available, PDFs can be read anywhere on any device. PDF files can include links, music, attachments, videos, and more, making it easier than ever to link the right content to the right file. PDF files are used for a variety of purposes, and experts might need to password protect them if they contain sensitive information. This results in one-of-a-kind document protection to keep data secure. You can also see who has access to a PDF, and if a password has been compromised, the necessary steps can be taken quickly. Well, as you can see, there's a lot of reasons why people use PDF files, but those are the main ones. So now that we've talked about the advantages, what are some disadvantages? PDF files also have some downsides and limitations, and let's talk about those now. Despite the benefits, some people are still hesitant to use PDF files, and one of the main reasons is that they can be susceptible to a variety of attacks. And most of the time, PDF files aren't password protected. But while the file format has been criticized for security, Adobe has been working to improve this. As PDFs are available for download from the internet, some web browsers do reject PDFs due to security concerns. One drawback to PDFs is they're typically quite large and could eat up a lot of space on your computer. So if you work with a lot of documents, this could be a major disadvantage. Because PDF files are normally A3 or A4 format, they can be difficult to read. This can be an advantage because they're easy to print, but viewing them on a screen with a 4:3 or a 16:9 ratio can be difficult. PDF is the most widely used publishing format on the internet. But while PDF files can be printed, the quality is usually lower than a proper graphics file. It is possible to create print quality PDFs, but creating them with lots of images requires third-party tools, which can affect image quality. Well, there you have it. Now you know what a PDF file is and the advantages and disadvantages of using them. Let us know in the comment section down below if you have any thoughts, and don't forget to like this video and subscribe to the Wondershare Repairit YouTube channel. Thank you so much for watching, stay safe, and I'll see you next time.